Tonight, there's a new plan for the old Sears in St. Paul. Heidi Wigdahl joins us now with more on the vision to turn it into a community hub. Hi, Heidi.
Hi, Rena. It's still in the early stages of redevelopment. The Sears building has sat empty for nearly 5 years. This summer, Asian Media Access bought the property for $8.2 million. Now we have a closer look at what it could become. A few years from now, this vacant property, once home to Sears in St. Paul, could look a lot different.
We wanted to be focused on helping the community, right? What can we do to make a difference, to make the community better?
John Yang is the executive director of the Asian American Business Resilience Network. The nonprofit is collaborating on the project with Asian Media Access, who bought the property. They have a vision of creating a community hub, recently releasing these photos for inspiration. Plans include a sports and digital arts-focused charter school, a wellness center, food court, 3D museum, and event center, also a Zen garden and kids zone. They're also planning on at least 5 new buildings on the 17-acre lot, with another focus on housing and office space.
It's all the communities. We're working Frogtown, Rondo, all types of background cultures.
But they need more investors and partnerships. Yang says they're looking at all their options for funding, but he estimates it could take $10 to $20 million alone to develop just the Sears building. Architects and engineers are currently evaluating the building to see if it can be restored. Because of its location, the Capital Area Architectural and Planning Board will need to approve any plans.
It's exciting. I think a lot of people don't know yet, but the impact that we'll have for the community around, especially the state capital, is going to be for generations to come.
Yang says they're aiming to start the redevelopment process next year. One of the things they're doing to raise awareness about the project is hosting a marketplace with food and retail vendors in the old Sears parking lot. It's part of their vision to have something similar in the building one day. The next St. Paul marketplace is happening this weekend from 11 a.m. to 6 p.m. on both Saturday and Sunday. Julie.
All right. Thanks, Heidi.